Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. This is an episode of MakerBox Mondays and today I'm going to talk about composite copper from Protopasta. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is one of the metal filaments and this one is from Protopasta and called composite copper. This is a HT PLA mixed with copper powder and can be sanded and polished to get a metallic look. And I tried to finish two parts and show you those. It states here on the label the filament is 1.75x times denser than a normal PLA, and you can feel the weight of the parts. Like my maker coin is a lot heavier than a normal maker coin, and this Omnum is quite heavy. I'm gonna show you the prints. So the first print is the maker coin, and this print came out pretty good. This is totally unpolished side, and to polish a model like this you really would need a tumbler, and I don't have a tumbler, so it's impossible to probably sand down this side to get it to shine with the copper. But here on the other side I sanded down the letters and you can see the shine on the letters. It was sanded down, I went down to 1200 grit sandpaper, and it has a very good metallic shine to it, and copper flakes shine through if you spend a little bit time on polishing. But print wise it was very easy to print with this filament. I printed at 215 degrees those samples and it came out pretty much great. I used the temperature I had been using on the Hi-Fi Blue from Protopasta, and this filament printed out with the same temperature without any issues and came out excellent, and the maker coin is quite good. And like I said, the metallic parts show very nicely through, and if I had a tumbler I would be able to make this part shine also. Now it's just a medium dark brown color. But the next print I did was the Omnum by Tessa or Sparky Base 5, and this model printed out quite nice, and here you can see it's unfinished on this side, and on this side I polished it down with sandpaper, and also when I was done polishing I sprayed a little bit of clear coat on it to make it shine a little bit more. But you can see the copper flakes in the reflection, you can see it coming through quite nicely on this print also. It was quite some work to sand this model with some paper. I really need to get a tumbler for those types of filament to get them to shine, and I didn't try to weather it with some chemicals and make it green like I've seen some people do with copper filaments, but that's some technique that you can do also. Finally, I made this bullet, and this is like a shell model I created for a small cannon shell. Actually, I was running out of filament in the end, and I decided just to finish it off with a red filament, so it's like a bullet shell, and that was not planned initially. But I just ran out of filament and saved the print by replacing the filament on the MK3 printer by pausing the print and doing the filament change. This I polished also with sandpaper, and this hasn't been sprayed. This is just sandpaper down to 2500 grit, and it's very shiny and comes out excellent. And you can maybe should have done more work with a more coarse sandpaper to get the errors out, especially here in the top part. There are some layer lines still visible, but you can get the idea of having just using sandpaper, you can get this look to it, and it came out pretty good as a small shell for a cannon. And the red explosion part is ready here. So this came out pretty good. So those were the three models I printed out with composite copper from Protopasta. This filament is quite heavy, and there was a little bit less filament in length wise in this sample than I normally get, so I have fewer samples to show you than maybe normal. But this filament printed very easily and I had no issues printing, and this is something, if you have a tumbler to finish the part, you can try this out and get more metallic look on complicated models. And it's quite difficult to sand all the small details in a normal model, and in a model like the maker coin, I would just ruin the model if I would use sandpaper. So you really need to have a tumbler if you're gonna make the best use of metal filament like this. But if you have a tumbler, you should give this filament a go. It can give you excellent results, and I really like the weight to it. And for like creating statues or something, it has a extra feel to hand this over to somebody, and versus a plastic PLA normal part. So it's quite special to have a very heavy 3D printed model. So this was quite good experience. But this was my quick look at the Protopasta composite copper. I hope you liked this video and format of one filament per video. And I'm gonna try to continue that on a scheduled basis on Mondays. But for now, I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.